When does a differential equation have a solution? When is there a unique solution? I'm Matthew Wright at St. Olaf College, and in this video, I will explain a simple theorem that gives conditions under which a first-order ordinary differential equation has a unique solution. Consider the first-order ordinary differential equation dy dt equals f of t, y, with initial condition y of t0 equals y0. Before we try to find a solution, we should answer two questions. First, does a solution exist? We would like to know that this initial value problem is actually solvable before we work too hard to find a solution. Second, if a solution exists, is it unique? This question is important because if this differential equation models a physical system, we need to know that we have a unique solution before using the solution to make a prediction about the system. Otherwise, if there are multiple solutions, how would we know that we have chosen the right one to make the prediction? Fortunately, we have a theorem that gives simple conditions under which this initial value problem has a unique solution. Informally, the theorem says that if f of t, y is a continuous function near the point t0, y0, then a solution exists. Additionally, if the partial derivative of f with respect to y is also continuous near the point t0, y0, then the solution is unique. First, let's talk about existence of the solution. Suppose f of t, y is a continuous function in a rectangle containing all points t, y, with t between a and b, and y between c and d. If t0, y0 is a point in this rectangle, then there exists a positive real number epsilon and a function y of t, defined for all t from t0 minus epsilon to t0 plus epsilon, that solves the given initial value problem. In other words, as long as the function f of t, y is continuous in a rectangle, even a tiny rectangle that contains the point t0, y0 in its interior, then there exists a function y of t that solves the differential equation that passes through the point t0, y0, and this function is defined in at least a tiny interval around that point. Let's look at an example. Dy dt equals y divided by t. For any point t0, y0 with t0 not equal to 0, the function f of t, y equals y divided by t is continuous in a rectangle containing t0, y0. Thus, the existence theorem tells us that a solution exists through the point t0, y0. However, the function f of t, y equals y over t is not continuous at points of the form 0, y0. It's not even defined when t equals 0, and thus the theorem doesn't tell us whether any solution goes through these points. Second, let's talk about uniqueness. Suppose f of t, y and the partial derivative of f with respect to y are both continuous functions in a rectangle containing all points t, y with t between a and b and y between c and d. If t0, y0 is a point in this rectangle, then there exists a unique solution y of t, defined for all t from t0 minus epsilon to t0 plus epsilon that solves the initial value problem. In other words, if the hypotheses of the uniqueness theorem are met, and if you think there are two functions, y1 and y2, that both satisfy the initial value problem on the interval from t0 minus epsilon to t0 plus epsilon, then in fact the two functions are the same, y1 equals y2, on this interval. Since the conditions for the uniqueness theorem are stronger than those for the existence theorem, the two theorems are often combined and stated as one existence and uniqueness theorem. Returning to our example, dy dt equals y divided by t. We said earlier that a solution exists through any point t0, y0 with t0 not equal to 0. Since the function f of t, y equals y over t, and its derivative with respect to y, df dy equals 1 over t, are both continuous in a rectangle containing such a point, the uniqueness theorem tells us that the solution through this point is unique. However, as before, the theorem doesn't tell us what happens at points where t equals 0. What is this unique solution? Either by separating variables or making a good guess, we can see that y equals y0 divided by t0 times t, this linear equation, satisfies the initial value problem. Thus, we now know that this line is the unique solution through any point t0, y0, where t0 is not equal to 0. What happens when t is 0? Remember that the theorem doesn't tell us anything in this case. In fact, the differential equation is not defined when t equals 0, because it involves division by t, so it doesn't make sense to talk about solutions when t equals 0. However, let's multiply both sides of the differential equation by t to obtain a new differential equation, t times dy dt equals y. Any solution of the old differential equation also satisfies this new differential equation, at least when t is not equal to 0, but now it makes sense to ask about solutions where t does equal 0. In this example, we see two things that can happen. First, many solutions pass through the point 0, 0. Specifically, the differential equation t times dy dt equals y is satisfied by any line y equals c times t, and all of these lines pass through the origin. However, no solution passes through any point 0, y0 with y not equal to 0. To see this, note that if t equals 0, then the left side of the differential equation is 0, and so y, the right side, must be 0 as well. When using the existence and uniqueness theorem, keep two caveats in mind. First, the theorem only makes a statement about what happens near t0, y0, in some, possibly small, interval around this point. It doesn't say anything about what happens far from this point. It could be that there is a unique solution near t0, y0, but multiple solutions elsewhere. Second, the theorem is not an if and only if statement. If the hypotheses for the theorem are not satisfied, then the theorem does not make any conclusion at all. We conclude with one more example. Consider the differential equation dy dt equals 3y to the 2/3. Since the right-hand side, f of t, y equals 3y to the 2/3, is continuous everywhere, a solution exists through any point t0, y0. However, the partial derivative of f with respect to y is 2y to the minus 1/3, which does not exist when y equals 0, so the theorem does not say whether a solution through a point t0, 0 is unique. We find that the general solution is y of t equals quantity t plus c cubed for some constant c, yet there is also an equilibrium solution y equals 0. Thus, there are two solutions through each point where y is 0, and so the solution through any point on the t-axis is not unique.